thank you. We thank you because you are very faithful. We thank you because you love us. You loved us. You love us and you continue to love us. Thank you for your faithfulness. We give you praise in Jesus' name. Thank you. Hallelujah. Let's give the Lord praise. I must now get to the business of the day. Before I do that, I need to do the needful in terms of protocol and decorum. And appreciate the presence of the pastors here this morning. Under the able leadership of the senior pastor. And acknowledge their spouses as well. I also have to acknowledge the various leadership structures that obtains in the church. And to thank you to continue saving the church in the leadership role. Even during these difficult times. When we expect you to lead visually most of the time. And we are glad that you have taken the mantle during such a time as this and continue saving the children of God. And also thank the members for continuing saving the Lord. Even those that are here, I thank you for continuing to be part of this ministry. We believe that very soon COVID-19 will be over and we will meet the way we are used to meeting. Hallelujah. So as I was preparing to come and share the word of the Lord, I had an honest and an open engagement with God. And I had said to God, how do I come before your people when your people are exposed to so much stress, to so much duress? What do I say to them? What do I say to a member who has in their possession a separation letter where the company says, we are no longer able to continue with you? And they are holding onto that letter and maybe they are not even able to share the news with their spouses and their children. Because the children will ask, what's happening to scholarship, to our school? And I said, God, how do I engage with people when they are going through that? What do I tell your church when men of God have to come up here and say to their members, please alternate when it comes to coming to church? What do I say? How do I encourage the servant of the Lord? What do I say to a student who spend most of their time at home and more most of their time, more time at home than at school, because there has been an outbreak in their school and they have to face examination time. What do I tell them? How do I encourage them?
Ke buisana jang le moithuti o e leng gore o ntse le nako e ntse a le kwa lapeng go na le kwa sekolong ka gore ne go tlhagogile mogare ke ba raya ke reng ga e le gore jaanong ba tshwanetse ba kwala tlhatlhobo.
How do I frame my message such that when I say God is good, nobody will ask how so?
Ke ba moletsa wa me jang gore e re ke raya batho ke re Modimo molemo e ba go sa nne le ope o tantayang a re o raya jang.
And the Lord gave me a message
mi morena ampha molaetsa
in my difficult moment
mona go nya ya pitlagano.
He said, just go up there and tell them to move on.
O ntetse a re tsama go bo ba ra hore ba gatele pele.
Go tell them to keep on going.
Tsama ya o ye go ba bolella gore ba tswelle ba tlhabela pele.
Hallelujah.
Amudimo abakwe.
So that is my encouragement to you this morning.
Ka jalo ke yone kgothatso ya me mo go lona mo mosong ono.
That despite the situation, despite the circumstances.
Gore go tsa kgatlhalesege seemo.
Keep on moving.
Tswelela o tlhabele pele.
And he gave me the experience of that great nation of Israel.
Mi an mphabu itemogelo ja chaba e kholo ya o ya Israele.
That they came a time in their lives.
Gore go ile ga nna le nako mo matshelong a bone.
When the Lord heard their cry.
Ha morena a utlileng sello sa bone.
Because they were living in slavery, in servitude under the Egyptians of King Pharaoh.
Ka go nne ne ba tshela mo kgatellong mo bogobeng jwa khosi faro wa ba egepeto.
And then there came a time when the Lord said, I have heard thy cry.
Me gatla nako e morena na re ke utlile sello sa bone.
And I'm taking them to the promised land.
Ibile ke ba isa go le hatseng la tshulofetso.
I'm taking them to their fulfillment.
Ke ba isa go phithellong ya bone.
Despite what they are going through.
Go sa kgatlhalese gore ba raletseng.
And there was excitement all over.
Me ga nna le boipelo gongwe le gongwe.
Because it was clear the Lord had spoken.
Ka go nne ne go papaletse gore Modimo o buile.
Because the Lord had been speaking.
Ka go nne Modimo na ntse a tsweletse a bua.
And the Bible says that they were so sure that they even decided to pick the remains of Joseph, their forefather.
Me Bible ya re bao ba tlhomame mo e leng gore ba tsaya tshwetso ya go tsaya marapo a ga ntatemogolo a bone Josepha.
Because their time had come.
Ka go nne nako ya bone ne e fitlhile.
And their journey to fulfillment started.
Me leeto la bone go ya phitlhellong labo le simolotse.
Because the Lord had remembered them.
O ile a ba gopola.
Hallelujah.
A Modimo a bakwe.
And then their journey to fulfillment begins.
Meleto la bone go a phitlhellong la simolla.
That is why today I want to encourage us on the message entitled The Journey to Fulfillment.
Ke ka mo ke ratang gore kgotlatsa ka molaetsa wa setlhogo sa leeto go ya phitlhellong.
What happens when we undertake this journey?
Go iragalang ha re tsaya loeto le.
Hallelujah.
Modimo a bakwe.
The journey to fulfillment.
Loeto go ya phitlhellong.
The Bible, let's take our reading from chapter 2 of Exodus, verse number 23.
Re tsaya padi ya rona go tswa mo dikhuduga wa bobedi kgaolo ke ya masome a mabedi le boraro.
Or we can skip to Exodus chapter 14 because I've already alluded to what's happened in chapter 2.
Kgotsa re ka ya ko dikhuduga kgaolo ya lesome le bone ka gonne ke setse ke buile se se iragetseng ka kgaolo ya bobedi.
Because the Bible says that now their journey began.
Ka gonne Bible ya re jaanong leeto la bone la simolola.
With all the confirmations.
Ka tlhomamisetso yotlhe.
With all the certainties.
Go na le tlhomamiso yotlhe.
And the Bible says that as they continued in the journey.
Mme Bible ya re ba tsweletse ka leeto.
Suddenly. The Red Sea appeared. And the Bible says that suddenly,
Bible ya re khabagare,
from the rear,
go tswa ko morago,
appeared the Egyptian army.
Ga bonagala sesole sa baegepeto.
And to the front,
mme ko pele,
was the Red Sea.
E le lewatle le lehibidu.
And what happens when along the way suddenly the Red Sea appears?
Jano go iragala jang ha ile gore motseleng ga ba gare lewatle le lehibidu la iponagatsa.
What happens when, as the church, you had come to a point at the beginning of the year, the servant of the Lord has come to you and he has said, we are moving on unto the time of the fulfillment of the scriptures.
And
the fulfillment of the scriptures mean a lot of different things to different people. And to one, it means being able to get employment. To the other means being able to go on and establish a family. And then all of a sudden the Red Sea throws the spanner in the works.
Hallelujah.
We need to understand what goes on in the mind of that particular, that individual who all of a sudden they come face to face with the Red Sea in their lives. Does that then mean that God had not spoken? Does that then mean that God had forsaken them? And verse 15 of the book of Exodus, chapter 14, reads
thus.
And the Lord said unto Moses, wherefore criest thou unto me? Tell the Israelites to break camp.
Raya bana ba Israel ba gatele go pele.
Ye ke so tseng yene ya re.
The one I'm reading.
Speak unto the children of Israel.
Ya re bua le bana ba Israel.
That they go forward.
Gore ba gatele pele.
So the instruction of the Lord even this morning to the church.
Ka jalo taelo ya morena le mo kerekeng mo mosong o.
Is that even during these difficult times that we are going through? We have to go forward. We are not those that go backwards unto destruction, says the Bible. But we are those that move forward, even unto the saving of the souls. So going backward was never an option for them. Because the one that had called them was faithful. And he was beckoning, saying, come, come to them, even across the sea. Hallelujah. So going backward is not an option, child of God. We need to press on and press on. Hallelujah. And I'm not saying this with the intention to undermine your efforts. I know pretty well that it can get quite difficult. But we have started this journey. And he that has started with you is faithful enough to bring this journey even unto completion. That is the reason why you need to press on in your trusting in him. Hallelujah. His encouragement is that tell my children to go forward. Hallelujah. I'm well aware of how difficult it can become. Because as you stand facing the Red Sea, a lot of things can happen. One of the things that happen is that, you know, sometimes it appears like there is no clarity. There is so much uncertainty, there is so much confusion. And you are asking yourself a lot of questions about your life. And as they stood there looking at the Red Sea, they could not see Canaan. And the only thing that they could see was bodies and bodies and bodies of water beating about each other. They could not even hear the sound of the flow of milk and honey. Because the Lord had said, I'm taking you to a place that is flowing with milk and honey. But Canaan remained a reality even during that time. The fact that they could not see Canaan did not make it not to exist. There, the anxiety and the pain of waiting could not, you know, make it to be not existent. And I remember the story of Abraham. The Bible says the Lord came to him and said, I'm taking you to a place where I will transform you into a great nation. He was taking him to this very place we're talking about called Canaan. But the Bible says the Lord said to him, I will show you, just go, I will show. There was no clarity. Except the word of the Lord that said, I will be with you, never to forsake, never to abandon you. Sometimes I try to imagine Abraham breaking the news to his wife Sarah. We are leaving this place. I have tendered my resignation at work and we are going. And the wife says, to where? To a place the Lord will show me. I imagine the children at school bidding their peers adieu, bidding their peers farewell. We are leaving. And the peers ask to where? They say, no, we don't know as yet. Even our father is clueless as to where we are going. The only thing that was certain to him was the faithfulness of the one that had deposited the message in his heart. It was the faithfulness of the one who says, even today, keep on moving. Keep on clinging to the principles of the Bible. Hallelujah. And the other thing that happens as you face the Red Sea of your life, It's just a feeling of confusion. You know, you just feel so confused. So lost. But you keep on moving because he that has called you is faithful. You keep on moving. Even when it does not make sense, you keep to the principles of God. If you are a businessman and now they are enticing you to take kickbacks to keep your company floating, you say, I cannot go this way because it is against the principles of God. You have stayed in one scale for far too long. And your supervisor keeps on enticing you to do stuff that is out of line so that you can get your promotion. The pressure is there. The difficulty is there. But my encouragement to you is that you keep to the work of the Lord. Keep to the word of the Lord. You are out of employment. And there are enticements along the way for you to do certain things that are out of the way so that you can get employed. You are a child of God. Keep on moving. Hallelujah. You may be saying, Mr. Robert, you don't understand what I'm going through. I understand. But what is even more critical is that the one that has called you understands more than I do. He understands your frustrations at work. When I was giving an example this morning, and I was telling them that, you know, I got to a point in my professional life where I stagnated for 9, if not 10 years. No movement, no promotion, nothing. But my supervisors will come to me and say, Mr. Robert, we love your work ethic. We love it. And their explanation would be there are no posts. And of course they were right, there would be no posts. And I suppose this is the language that a lot of us are familiar with. And you stagnate for that long. And when an opportunity came, when suddenly or finally there was a post, they went out and brought a drunkard who came staggering into the post.
And he was staggering right into the post.
So I understand your frustrations. But I kept on moving. I kept to my principles. And there are many that kept on moving. They kept to the principles. Because he that calls you, that has called you, is faithful, and he calls you to certain standards that he has set himself. And your promotion does not come from men, it comes from God. Hallelujah. I kept on moving. And because he is faithful, after those 10 years of drought, and the Lord remembered me. As he remembers his children who keep on waiting, who keep on moving. And when the time for my promotion came, the Lord decided that within 2 years I get promoted 3 times.
Morena atsa tshwetso ya gore mo dingwageng tse pedi ke tla tlhatlhosiwa maemo makgetho a mararo.
They give me this great. The Lord says, give him another one.
Mme ba ntlhatlhosa bampa ha morena re nya.
They give me that second great. The Lord says, give him another one.
Ba ntlhatlhosa mo go aga go dimo nyana.
They give me third great. God says, give him another one.
Mme a latela morena re mo neeleng a mang.
Until I got to a point when I said, in my heart, maybe the Lord should stop here so that I grow in this position. And I look at my wife and say, are you happy now? And I could tell she doesn't have any problem with me saying, the Lord, wait a moment. So my encouragement to you is that you must keep on moving, stick to the principles of the Lord. And the other thing that happens as you come face to face with the Red Sea of your life is, you know, there will be this wave of noise as you stand before the sea. All that you hear is this angry sea. Noise all over, trying to drown the voice of God so that you don't get to hear God when he says it's time to move. Spending so much time looking at this door that has closed, so much that you even fail to notice a new door that is being opened. That is where the devil wants you. So my encouragement to you this morning is that even in the midst of that noise, keep on moving. The pressures of life will come. And the devil will keep you too busy to even notice it when your time to move has come. So as you stand by the Red Sea that has suddenly erupted before you, be attentive to the word of God. And keep on moving. And when that time comes, when you come face to face with your Red Sea, which stands between you and your fulfillment, you know, you may feel so alone. So very alone. They were alone because they had been taken out of Egypt, and it was now only them face to face with the Red Sea. And the Bible says that God Almighty, he changed tact. And because we know that there was an angel before them, the Bible says that God withdrew that angel. Because the Bible says that there was a pillar of cloud to lead them. That is in verse number 19. The Bible says that the Lord withdrew that pillar so that it came to the back.
Bible ya re modimo a goga pillar ya o go isa go morago.
You know there are times in this journey when you come face to face with your Red Sea.
Gona le dina go mo
when suddenly the people that have been there, when suddenly your friends withdraw from you, and you feel so alone. And before you consider to backslide, I want to encourage you to consider this. The Bible says that they moved on. Probably those people had to be withdrawn from your life because the Lord realizes that now you are strong enough to stand on your own. Probably they were becoming your God, and now they are being shifted so that you can look at God. In the Bible, this is another reason the Bible says that now they were withdrawn to come to the back so that they can bring confusion to the enemy. So sometimes this happens as a tactic by God. When he changes tactic, maybe now God adira cowhorn formation. Those who have studied Shaka Zulu tactics, and then you don't get to see the transition. And the Bible says, upon realizing this, the children of Israel looked unto Moses and said, why did you bring us to this place? Were there no graves in Egypt where we could die?
Because
the one that was calling them was faithful, and Moses knew this. He had to say to them, keep your eyes fixed on him, the author and the finisher of your faith.
And
what I love about this God, what I love about this story, is that the Red Sea does finally part. Is that ultimately the children of God do go through. No matter how long the night drags on, ultimately birds begin to sing, announcing the arrival of morning. Weeping may last for the night, but the Bible says joy ultimately comes in the morning. If we hang in there long enough, then we will experience our morning. If we hang there long enough, then the Lord will say to you, well done, my faithful servant. You hang on even unto the end, because the Lord is faithful. And we must remain faithful even during this difficult time. You still have, the Bible still says, husbands must love their wives, and wives must submit to their husbands even during this difficult of times. The principle of God has not changed. Just hang in on there. In the name of Jesus.
Kalina la ga Jesu.
Hallelujah.
A gonne jalo.